Hey everyone. Thanks for returning to the Uncle Starts Fire channel, where this 45-year-old uncle records my fire, or financial independence retire early journey, which only started 5 years ago. I hope that my journey can inspire the other uncles and aunties that it is never too late to start investing for your retirement. In addition, how this channel differentiates itself from other channels, is that all content and everything I say, is always 100% based on my real investment portfolio. For example, I will only provide performance updates or comments on the shares and REITs I am invested in, and I will share exactly how much I hold for each share or REIT. This way, you can be assured, chop stamp, confirmed, that I have vested interest in what I say. Starting my last video, I have switched to using the AWS text-to-speech service, called AWS Polly, and I am loving my new voice in the video. You know this uncle, is camera shy, so I am not appearing on YouTube, okay? Just my content, 100% based on my retirement investments. Okay, let's get into today's video to hear more of my AWS voice. Ha ha! In this video, I will be sharing about the performance of my commercial REITs portfolio, year to date to June 9, 2023. Let me quickly go through the template I am using for video, to present useful information to you on each of the commercial REITs. As I go through the performance of each of my commercial REIT, the name of the REIT and its stock quote is shown at the top. So the first REIT I want to talk about is CapitaLand Integrated Commercial Trust. Then, this figure shows the how much I am holding for this REIT. This figure shows the average price change in 2023 so far, that is, 1st of January to June 9, 2023. And I show the price chart for this on right, from Yahoo Finance. For CapitaLand Integrated Commercial Trust, the share price has dropped by 4.4% so far. And this figure shows the dividend yield on an annualized basis. This is 5.5% per annum, and from my holdings of $24,217, I would currently expect to receive dividends of $1,331 a year. For the commercial REITs, I will be presenting the rental reversion of the REIT broken down by the sectors, and the change in tenant sales as the relevant performance metrics. For CapitaLand Integrated Commercial Trust, the retail space has done very well. The rental reversion is up 6.0%, with tenant sales up 10.2%. In case you are not aware, the rentals charged by many retail REITs consist of two components, a fixed component, and a variable component which is based on a certain percentage of what the tenants were able to sell at their shops. So the change in tenant sales is important for the operational performance of the REIT. CapitaLand Integrated Commercial Trust's office space also performed not too badly, with rental reversion up 4.2%. Office tenants tend not have a variable component, so no tenant sales will be presented. Next up is Frasers Centrepoint Trust. It is a pure play on Singapore's suburban retail space, which is one of the most resilient property sector in Singapore. During economic downturns, suburban retail space is expected to continue to do well. This is because all uncles and aunties, and the young people, will still need to buy their daily necessities, or chill with friends over coffee. The only time when suburban retail space was affected was during the COVID lockdowns, which this uncle hopes will never come back.
That as operators have to limit how many shoppers may enter and use only some entrances to regulate exit.
With the COVID restrictions removed, just look at the jump in tenant sales for Frasers Centrepoint Trust. Basically, its tenant sales went up by a whopping 35.3%, really impressive. Its rental reversion is rather flat at 1.9%, but I hope with the trend of sales going up continuing, the rental reversion should improve further. Its share price has gone up by 4.3% so far this year, with a reasonably attractive dividend yield of 5.6%. I hold $7,884 of shares in the REIT, and I expect to receive $442 a year. For Lendlease Global Commercial REIT, the share price has declined by 8.5% this year, with a dividend yield of 7.4%. This means that even after taking into account the dividends, the REIT is still in the red for me. However, I think this REIT has a relative good mix of stable office space, and recovering prime Orchard Road retail space. In case you are not aware, its office space is relatively stable because it is office building leased to the Ministry of National Development in Singapore all the way until 2044, and a large office building in Milan, Italy, leased to Sky Italia till 2032. They have rental reviews every few years. For its retail space, it is the owner of 313 Somerset and Gem in Jurong. Based on my holdings of $17,157, I expect to receive a dividend of $1,270. Its rental reversion is not too bad, ranging from 3.3% to 4%. Next is Mapletree Pan Asia Commercial Trust, with share price decline of 3.6% so far this year, and a dividend yield of 5.8%. I hold $9,660, with an expected dividend of $560. Many investors have mixed feelings when it comes to Mapletree Pan Asia Commercial Trust. In its previous life as a purely Singapore REIT, it was the darling of many investors, including many of my friends. We viewed it as one of the top dividend stocks, with its gem property, Vivo City, doing extremely well. It is always crowded, being the gateway to Sentosa, and the tenant mix was fantastic. However, last year, the parent decided to merge the Singapore REIT with another of its REIT which focuses on Hong Kong and China. Sounds good on paper, but that REIT wasn't doing as well. As you can see, the rental reversion for Hong Kong is down 12.7%. And comparing the tenant sales between Hong Kong's 9.3% and Singapore's 30.6%, you can see the difference. In fact, many of my friends are swearing off Mapletree Pan Asia Commercial Trust. I have sold some of my holdings as well. I am keeping some as I think there could be potential for Hong Kong's recovery with the reopening of Hong Kong and China. Talking about China's reopening, the next REITs is CapitaLand China Trust. The share price has declined by 11.2% so far this year, and it pays a dividend of 6.8% yield, which is attractive given the quality of its malls and properties in China. I hold $40,895 of CapitaLand China Trust, and currently, I expect to receive $2,781 a year as dividends. If you recall, CapitaLand China Trust used to consist entirely retail malls in China. After a revamp of the REIT's mandate, it was expanded to include business parks and logistics parks. In other words, CapitaLand China Trust will be the only REIT vehicle for its parent, CapitaLand, for assets in China. You know that CapitaLand is one of the largest property companies in Asia, and China accounts for the second largest country of exposure other than Singapore. So CapitaLand China Trust will have a steady stream of assets that the parent will inject into the REIT over time. With the COVID reopening, CapitaLand China Trust tenant sales have improved by 15.4%, with rental reversion of 3.1%. Its business parks and logistics parks had relatively flat rental reversion. The next investment I am presenting is on Link REIT, which is listed in Hong Kong. The share price declined 17.5% this year, largely due to a weak consumer demand in Hong Kong prior to the COVID reopening, and a huge rights issuance to invest in several properties in Singapore. The funny thing was that I invested in Link REIT to diversify from Singapore, but this REIT invested back in Singapore to diversify away from Hong Kong. Oh well. The current dividend yield is 9.4%, but is expected to reduce based on the rights issuance. Its rental reversions are healthy, at 7.1% for its retail space, and 5.3% for its car parks, and the tenant sales increased by 6.2% year-on-year. I invested in Link REIT previously and provided more details on Link REIT in my video on the investments in March 2023. Finally, let's talk about a sad story, Manulife US REIT. Well, as you can see, the share price has dropped by 42.7% so far this year. The high dividend yield of 25.3% is largely due to the dramatic drop in share price. I hold $23,348 in Manulife US REIT, and expect to receive dividends of $5,907 a year. Wow, a 25% dividend yield. Doesn't that mean you can recover your capital investments in 4 years? Recall, this is a sad story, so there are risks involved in investing in Manulife US REIT at this point in time. Balancing the risk and rewards, this uncle invested in some more Manulife US REIT last month. I did a more comprehensive video about Manulife US REIT in my previous video, with the link in the top right corner. I have provided the occupancy rate for Manulife US REIT because for all the other REITs, the occupancy is consistently close to 100%. But for Manulife US REIT, the occupancy is at 86.1%, dropping some 5.6 percentage points over the year. With the strategic review ending, and the parent, Manulife, starting to be more active in supporting the REIT, this uncle is hoping that the sad story will end with a happy ending. And now, to present this uncle's total holdings in the commercial REITs portfolio. In total, I have a holding of $127,863 in the 7 commercial REITs. The portfolio didn't do well, down 14% year-to-date, dragged down by Manulife US REIT, but as you can see, generally the commercial REITs didn't do well this year. This is because interest rates have been increasing, and REITs, being highly leveraged, were affected. My dividend yield is at 10.0%, so overall, I expect to receive $12,786 of dividends a year. Okay, that's a wrap. Thanks everyone for watching. This uncle really appreciates the views and likes I have received for my videos. A special shout out to Jamie and Vinay, who commented on my videos, and thanks for your kind words. These are motivations for this uncle to continue making videos in my free time. I hope you find the video useful. See you next time.